So in this video, I'm going to talk about breadcrumbs. What are breadcrumbs? What are its role in SEO? In this video, we will cover how you can add breadcrumbs in your website and how breadcrumbs impact your website. Hello everyone, I'm Shivani Goyal. Welcome in WsCube. So let's just start with the basic definition about breadcrumbs. What is a breadcrumb? So breadcrumbs trail is a small menu usually located at the top of a page, used as a navigational ad, which shows the path to go from the current page back to the home page. Let me give you with the help of one of the example here, that is this. Here you can see that we have this particular page. This is our landing page here, and before this landing page, here you can see we have one home page and we have another page. So this navigation is known as breadcrumb trail here. So breadcrumb trail starts from the home page, then it shows the category name and then the current page. So each step in the path is clickable. You can also open this particular category page here. You can also visit to this particular home page here. Now we have different type of breadcrumbs available. One is your hierarchy based breadcrumbs. Another one is your dynamic breadcrumbs, and then your history based breadcrumbs. So what are these? Let's understand one by one. First, we have hierarchy based breadcrumbs. Hierarchy based breadcrumbs are the typically breadcrumbs you can find on the blog or website that have a simple hierarchical structure. Here, let me give you one of the example of one of the company, that is Amazon here. Here you can see that we have this particular page, that is computer accessories and peripherals. This is our current page here, and here you can see that we have a hierarchy. That is electronics, which is your home page, computer and accessories, which is your category page, and computer accessories and peripherals, which is your current page. So this type of breadcrumb is known as hierarchy based breadcrumb, where we have hierarchy of your home page, category page, then you have current page. Next we have dynamic breadcrumb. So as its name shows, dynamic. So dynamic or attribute based breadcrumbs are used in case a product has many attributes. Here you can see we have one example here, that we have one e-commerce website, and this is the example here that this particular product belongs to shoes, sneakers, black and man. These are the attributes of the specific product here. So in that case, we can simply reflect that to make the navigation easier. So this type of breadcrumbs is known as dynamic breadcrumbs. Next we have history based breadcrumbs. The breadcrumbs path trail is built based on the pages a user has visited. Let's suppose here you visit this particular page. In this you further find any subcategory, then you simply visit them. Again you find any subcategory and you visit. So this type of navigation breadcrumb is known as history based breadcrumbs. Now the question is, why are breadcrumbs important? Why are breadcrumbs important for your website? Why you are using them? So simply just to make your navigation easier, because that's the main role of the breadcrumbs, and that this is the way user love them. Because if you simply put breadcrumbs here, then people also know about your previous pages, your category page, your home page. So they encourage people to visit more pages of a website just before they exit, and thus they reduce bounce rate. Also, they help search engine boards during the crawling and indexing phase, because when search engine crawler visit to your website and when they find that you again have some other pages as well, so they simply crawl the information which you also put on other pages as well. So crawler can identify the breadcrumbs and may use the breadcrumb structure to gather more information about the web page and your site. Google shows breadcrumbs information in the search engine result page instead of showing the parameter link of a page. So that is also one of the important features of breadcrumbs. So another feature you have is that Google can understand better about your site structure. You can also, it helps in increase your click-through rate. It also improves your SEO ranking, because if you have higher click-through rate, that correlates with your improved ranking in the search engine. And the more people who click through to your website, the more Google will favor your site in search results. And also low bounce rate, because breadcrumbs can lower your bounce rate since they are offering visitors a alternative way to browse your site. So these are the most important factors of breadcrumbs why we are using. Now, breadcrumbs SEO practice. In that case, you have to make sure that breadcrumbs are enabled and visible to the user. And you have to also make sure that the breadcrumbs which you created are mobile friendly, and you have to add breadcrumb schema as well. So these are one of the important factors for breadcrumbs. Let me show you a live demo on that, how you can add breadcrumbs in your website. For adding breadcrumbs, let me visit on my website. This is my website here, and in this particular website, we have one plugin here which is known as All-in-One SEO. First, you have to install this particular plugin. So, for installing this particular plugin, you have to visit on plugin section, and then you have to simply search All-in-One SEO. That is AIO SEO. That is the plugin here, and here you can find this is the plugin here. You have to simply click here. That is your install now, and after done with the installation part, you have to simply click on update. You have to simply click on activate. After done with your activation part, that particular plugin you can see in your left hand side. In your left hand side, just below the setting option, you can see All-in-One SEO plugin is there. In this particular plugin, you have to visit on journal setting. In your journal setting option, here you can see that we have free version available of this particular All-in-One SEO. In this particular free version, we can enjoy so many features here. But if you want to go with the pro section, you can also visit that. In your journal setting option, you simply visit on breadcrumbs. First, you have to make sure that your breadcrumb feature must be enabled. And all you need to do is to make sure that it's enabled and add a code snippet or short code to your site depending on where you want to show the breadcrumbs navigation. So first, we simply on that. Then we have different options available here. That is your short code, wingset, PHP code. In that case, what you have to do for PHP code, here you can see that we have simply a code there. So just by copying that particular code and pasting it in your theme editor, the breadcrumbs navigation will be displayed on all of your pages. This is the feature of your PHP code here. So you have to simply copy that code and simply paste it in your header section, header.php section. After that, we have short code here. So sometimes you may only want to show breadcrumbs navigation on specific pages. That's why we also added the option of show breadcrumbs on your individual posts and the pages using our WordPress short. In that WordPress short code here, you can see that we have a simple code here. You have to simply copy the code and paste it just below the page on which you just want to display that particular navigation. We can also create Gutenberg blog just to make it easier, and we can also choose that widget option. Then we have some settings here which we have to do. Here you can see that we have breadcrumb setting available here. This is a preview here. Here you can see about your website designing, because we know that your website design is important and you don't want anything to run it. So that's why we made it possible for us to change the breadcrumb separator. And here you can, this is the breadcrumb setting. And there are many variations to choose from, so you can easily find something that fits your taste and design. This is the preview here. This is the separator here. Here you can see separator, and we also have some other options as well. After that, we have home link, which is used to add or remove your home link page. So we also want to make it easier for you to add or remove your home page link from your breadcrumbs navigation. So we added the simple option to switch it on and off. If we simply put it on. We can also mention here, let's suppose here you can mention that is a home page. Home page table is home in the breadcrumbs navigation. And made is possible to change the home page table to the text of your choice. So after your home page option, next we have is your breadcrumbs prefix. In your breadcrumb prefix, you can also add your prefix and suffix here. After that, we have show blog page. So all of you amazing bloggers out there, pay extra attention to this. If you have a set of post page in your WordPress setting, you can show your blog page next to the home page in your breadcrumbs navigation. Here you can simply on that, and here you can add. If you want to set it off, you can also. So after your blog page, the next we have, you have to set your archive box. So we also want to make it easy for you to set the taxonomy or format of your archives. So we added the post type name, that is your smart tag by default, and give you the option to enter your own text before it. Next we have search result format. In that case, just like in the archive format, you can use the search result label as is or customize it with something like you search for or here's what I found for to entice people to click on the link. So this is your search result. Next we have 404 error format. So one breadcrumbs feature even lets you format the 404 error label and add instruction to what action users should take if they visit a broken link on your site. So this is crucial for your SEO and business, since most users immediately click away from your site when landing page on a 404 page. And here you can simply mention like your 404 page not found. This type of error you can use. Next we have current item. In that case, you can show current item, link current item. You can add accordingly, like which format you want. We want this to make customize your breadcrumbs navigation a simple and hassle-free process. So that's why we can use this particular feature. Next, we have some breadcrumbs template here. These are available in the pro version. In this particular template, here you can use your category and tags. You can use your by default categories for your categories and tags here. You can simply add in your category part in your pro version here. And you can also add it pages as well. Like you can add, use a default template, show home page link, show parent link item. You can use that. That is a quick process which is totally pain free for your users. But for this, you have to purchase that particular pro template here. You can also add your author here. Like you can simply add your author name at the end of the page here with the help of this pro template, or you can also enable your show page breadcrumb. That is, you can simply enter your own text just before the page number format if you wanted to show. For example, blog page and then the number. So you can simply mention that. You can also add your page format as well, just like your blog page, you can do that. You can also include or remove your unselected taxonomy terms. If you want, you can simply include or remove that. So these are some of the features you can find in the pro version of your breadcrumbs here. So if you want to go with that, you have to simply click on upgrade or pro your unlock template features. So this is all about your breadcrumbs, how you can simply add breadcrumbs in your website and how breadcrumbs help you and how it is important in terms of. Let me show you how these breadcrumbs look like. For this, we have to simply visit on this particular website. Let me visit that. Let me show you how these breadcrumbs look like. Let me visit on this particular page. This is our, here you can see that this is our current page, that is your marketing breadcrumbs. And here you can see SEO, digital marketing goals, home. These are your category pages and home is your home page. So this is how your breadcrumbs look like. So this is all about breadcrumbs. So thank you so much for watching this video.